So we've got this big tropical storm out in the Atlantic. It's far away, but what's next?
Far away, what's next? That's the question. That's the pressure on me, right?
Exactly. I put you on the spot.
It's headed in this general direction, but the key thing is it's a long way away. We've got a lot of time to watch this one, and a lot could happen with it. So we'll go over those factors for you in just a moment. Here's a live view outside at the noontime hour. A lot of sunshine across South Florida. We have seen some rain as well up on the Treasure Coast, but down through the Palm Beaches, things are looking pretty good. Mixture of sun and clouds and hot temperatures. Okay, on to Dorian. And there is a center of circulation on satellite imagery. Looks fairly organized. We can see the counterclockwise circulation rolling off to the west. Nice banding structure here. The rain bands kind of wrap around the center of circulation. And as the pressure lowers, the stronger the storm system. And again, judging by satellite data that we have out here, it is looking a little better organized on the satellite imagery for this afternoon. One thing it's fighting, a lot of dry air. This is water vapor imagery showing us the moisture content at the upper levels of the atmosphere. We see these orange shades, very dry conditions, and many times these systems can entrain some drier air in there, so it's certainly something we'll have to keep on top of, in addition to slightly cooler sea surface temperatures, so we'll watch that over the coming days. Here's a look at the 11 o'clock advisory. Motion is west-northwest at 17, pressure 999 millibars, and again, top wind speeds are at 60 miles per hour associated with Tropical Storm Dorian. Here's a track from the National Hurricane Center. Again, motion off to the west. There's Friday evening. A 60-mile-per-hour storm is the best thinking right now. Again, the intensity forecast certainly very much up in the air. We could be dealing with something a little stronger or a little weaker here, but again, approaching Puerto Rico north of there and then the Turks and Caicos as we head towards Tuesday evening. A 70-mile-per-hour tropical storm. Notice a window of possible movement. It does include Hispaniola. If it takes a southerly track, it will be a weaker storm system. A little more northerly track, it could be a little stronger. So a lot of details we still have to work out. We encourage you to tune back into us. Of course, our chief here, Mike Lyons, will have the latest coming up here tonight at 5. All right, looking at the radar, you can see these scattered showers blowing through the Treasure Coast. Vero, a little bit of light rainfall and out to the south here. Just light rain, but it was a lot heavier up on the Treasure Coast a little bit earlier today. Our weather being driven by this weather front to the north, westerly winds will carry the thunderstorms in here. We are probably going to get a little bit of break this afternoon, and future track has most of these showers kind of blooming through southern Palm Beach County and then just kind of partly sunny skies. Hot temperatures, though, everybody should make it into the lower 90s area wide. So we're going to go for 91 at Sebastian, 91 at Fort Pierce, 90 at Jensen Beach, and 92 in the Gardens. Mixture of sun and clouds and the overall rain chance, 30%. 7-day forecast goes like this. Here we've got upper 80s, low 90s, 30% coverage through the weekend, but all eyes on Dorian, and we'll keep you updated as we move along.
All right, Justin.